Talking about Malawi, it contributes to about 2% of the global cases of malaria. We are really burdened by this disease as a country. There's no one single method that we can use to control malaria. Currently, the main control tool that is being used is ITNs, which is the use of mosquito nets. And also we're using what we call IRS, that's indoor residual spraying, whereby we basically spray inside of the houses with insecticides. The World Health Organization and also through national malaria control programs, they are still looking for other complementary tools that can help in the fight against malaria.
The majority of my work makes use of satellite imagery to learn about the environment and see how that is connected with disease distributions. That works really well on large scales, so if you want to know about disease across a country, but when we go to a much smaller scale, so you want to know why one village is more at risk of disease than another, then the imagery we get from satellites, it just isn't higher resolution enough. So the benefit of moving from a satellite imagery-based project to a drone-based project is we get more control over that imagery. We can see these smaller scale water bodies. We can see what type of vegetation is in rivers and reservoirs to really try and find that connection between the malaria transmission and the environment. And realize quite quickly that while we, in theory, have the skills to collect the data and process it, trying to manage that alongside all the other activities of the project became a bit too much. So that's why we then connected up with GLOBHE and used the Crowddroning approach, as that allowed us to freed up our time to be able to focus on the field work, the kind of project management, the analysing of the data, while not having to worry about the more technical side.
GLOBHE is short for Global Health, and the mission with GLOBHE is to be a global drone service provider to help prevent and detect disease outbreaks around the world. GLOBHE were working in Malawi together with UNICEF, and so were the key actors behind Maladrone project, Liverpool School of Tropical Medicine. And we were connected in Malawi together because Liverpool School of Tropical Medicine had a need to scale up their data collection with drones, and GLOBHE was there to be able to assist that. Today the project has scaled so that we can deliver quality drone data on demand to the researchers at Liverpool School of Tropical Medicine, and by doing so also help Malawi and the National Malaria Vector Control to get more informed decisions about malaria breeding sites around the country.
GLOBHE has been very, very essential in my growth as a pilot and also in my business journey. We were contacted by GLOBHE to actually work with them on the Maladrone project. Tiu actually went with our team on the field in Kasungu to actually see what was happening and what was actually the need. At first, I just thought, okay, let me just go out and do some mapping. But when I got on site, it was actually different. I saw people who were actually down with malaria. I went to one house where I actually had parked. We wanted to set that as our station for charging and the like. Like, one house had four people that were down with malaria. It stopped being just about business. This was us using drone technology to actually solve real people's problems.
I believe that there is a gap that drones can fill. If you're really looking at how a disease transmission changes over very small areas, the information we can get from drone imagery is invaluable, and I don't know at this point how else we could get it.
The Maladrone project is definitely one of our most inspiring projects, where we and our local drone pilots around the world truly have the potential to help prevent malaria outbreaks. And that's, of course, a fascinating journey and an innovation to be a part of.